Hello, learners. I'm Nora Wanza. I want us to continue with the chapter of production planning. So we are in these four stages of preparation, where we have said we have the volume forecasting, we have the standard yields, we have the standard receipts, and we have standard portion sizes. So we start with the volume forecasting. What is volume forecasting? This is often referred to in other industries as production planning. It is a method of predicting the volume of sales of an establishment for a specified future period. This can be done by use of past records, current trades, current events. The sales of the establishment are broken down into the sales of each selling outlet and then broken down into the sales per main item. So there is objectives of volume forecasting for foods. Objectives are the same as aims, are the same as the reason, have the same importance why you do certain things. So why do we need to do volume forecasting for foods? One, to predict the total number of meals to be sold in each selling outlet of an establishment at each meal period. So when we do the volume forecasting, we are able to know at this time we are going to sell this number of food to this number of customers, and also to predict the menu choice of items by customers. You predict what your customers likely to eat, so you are going to prepare that menu. Number three, to facilitate purchasing, because you have already predicted what you are going to buy. Number 12, to ensure availability of all necessary ingredients, such that all the ingredients that are required are there. Next, to ensure that appropriate stock levels are held. Next, to control food costs in relation to sales or within cost limits in a profit-making establishment. Last, to enable the food controller to compare the actual volume of business done by each of the selling outlets with the potential volume of business as forecast, and for management to take action where necessary. So when this food and beverage controller will be taking these details, he will be doing a comparison between the total volume of sales, total number of customers, and the total number of main course items. Then, methods of volume forecasting. We have the time series analysis method. This is a quantitative method. When we say something is in quantitative, you can be able to count in 1, 2, 3. In numbers, you can be able to count. For forecasting, forecasting is seeing the future. It is a procedure which identifies information that forms pattern over a period of time. When using this method, forecasting is based on the basis of past data. The projection is meant from the past experience. It should be used when data are available and reliable. Forecasts are based on what has happened in a certain period of time in the past. What has happened in a certain period in the past may indicate what is likely to happen in the future. For example, sales in the past 5 years may be used to predict sales in future. So that's what we do by the volume forecasting. Then we have the Delphi technique. This method is used when past data are not available or reliable. If a new product is introduced and past data is available, there is a procedure for arriving at an agreement of opinion among a group of experts. Each expert gives his own opinion regarding what the future is likely to be. Each expert then reads the opinions of the other experts, and then he can revise his own opinion. So there are two stages of volume forecasting. The first one is the initial forecast. It is done once in a week in respect of each day of the following week. It is prepared in a week in advance and shows the estimated number of meals to be taken in each selling outlet, the estimated total price of each menu item for each day of the following menu week. So when we're looking at the initial forecast, there are four things that you need to take care of. You need to look at the past records, which are the sales histories. You also look at the advance bookings, and you look at the current events, what is happening recently. You also look at the current trades. what is going to the current trade, for example, when we have the trade fairs, the current trades when we are talking about the political issues, and also when we are talking about the coronavirus, which has really affected the hotel industry. You also look at the another additional information like the average spending power per customer, how much is the customer willing to spend? And the last method, the last stage of forecasting, is the final forecast. In the final forecast, a more accurate forecast usually takes place the day before the preparation and service of the particular meal. This takes into account the following: the previous day's food production and food sales figures, also the weather conditions. Is it cold? Because if it is cold, you are going to serve hot meal, and if it is very hot, you are going to serve cold meals. So you need to look at the weather conditions. Then there are aids to forecasting. We have number one, which is the cyclic menus. What is this cyclic menu? The cyclic menu is that menu that you used to be eating in your college, in your secondary schools, where you knew on Monday we are going to eat Githeri, Tuesday we are going to eat this and this. So that is a cyclic menu. These are series of fixed or some fixed menus which are repeated at a set period. The length of the period is usually related to the length of the menu. For example, we have 21 days for a menu of 3-course menu, 14 days for a menu of 5-course meal. Thus, the greater the choice of menu items, the shorter could be the length of the cycle of the menus. In practice, cyclic menus cover various periods, usually from 10 to 28 days. Cyclic menus are often used in canteens, hospitals, in restaurants offering a table dot menu. Why? Because in the table menu, dot menu, it's a menu that is fixed. For the a la carte menu, the customer chooses what they want. Then there is advantages of cyclic menus. One, you are able to know the likes and dislikes of the customers. Number two, repetition of menu items aid in preparation of standard dressings. Number three, staff scheduling and rostering may be accurately calculated when fairly precise requirements are known. But number four, by analyzing sales, popular dishes are identified, and there are disadvantages of cyclic menus. One, a range of menu items offered may be monotonous, leading to drop in sales, meaning it has been repeated many times, so the customers, they don't want it more. And number next, they need to be reviewed and rewritten frequently. Another thing that we look at, the another head after looking at the cyclic menu, now the other head is sales histories. These are detailed records of actual sales of menu items for each selling outlet. The actual sales should be recorded alongside with volume forecast sales for comparative and future forecasting purpose. Sales should be recorded daily and then totaled at the end of the week. Then there is purpose of sales history. One, provide an accurate record of food produced and sold compared with the forecast figures, which can be used as a reference for forecasting future demands. Then there are factors to consider when doing forecasting. One, study the previous year's business records along with these records. It is important to be informed the reasons behind the policy, the outcome, and accuracy of past forecast. Number two, consider the competition. What are your competitors doing? Number three, consider general economic situation of the nation and the industries can be studied. Number four, keep in touch with all publications in the field to help understand the trends. Thank you. In our next class, we are going to look at the standard youths.